Science Summary. A scientific review classifies mission concepts for searching observable evidence of technology by extraterrestrials, or technosignatures. They classify signatures based on how close humanity is to the capacity of developing the required technology to the level of a detectable footprint and the methods of detection, along with the possible ancillary benefits of the search for other ongoing astronomy. Conclusions of the study include a firm rationale for searching artifacts within the solar system. Scientists demonstrate a self-powered bionic robot at the deepest part of the ocean, at the Mariana Trench, to reduce stress on the electronic components from the immense pressure at a depth of almost 11,000 meters. The Chinese engineers embedded them spaced out in a silicone body. Pliable materials were used for its artificial muscles and wings, making it a so-called soft robot. The robots could be used for deep-sea exploration and environmental monitoring. Scientists propose compiling a library of the genomes, seeds, spores, sperms, and eggs of all 6.7 million species of plants, animals, and fungi that are recorded to exist on Earth today, and sending it to the Moon as a lunar ark. This backup could help ensure revivability and future studies of alterations of species alive today in the event of a major catastrophe on Earth or other unforeseen complications. According to the proposal, it could be locked in lava tubes about 100 meters below the lunar surface to secure it from solar and cosmic radiation and small meteorite impacts. This library of life could also be used for the creation of miniature ecosystems for supporting on-site presence of human operators on other bodies of the solar system. Physicists report that, based on their theoretical model, traversable microscopic wormholes may be possible and, unlike in previous theories, not require any exotic matter. Wormholes would connect two separate points in space via a curved region in space-time and would therefore allow faster-than-light communication and other transfers. If such are physically and technically possible, implications may include the possibility of time travel once such wormholes are connected, and increased chances of cross-influence of galactic and intergalactic civilizations. As no organisms but only microscopic amounts of atoms could be sent through such wormholes, the receiving end would need to have a receiver prepared. A German physicist describes a way warp drives sourced from known and familiar purely positive energy could exist. Previously unexplored space-time curvature geometries for so-called warp bubbles using superluminal self-reinforcing soliton waves. Warp drives would physically allow for up to faster-than-light speed travel and communication by bending space itself, rather than only accelerating the spacecraft. While the described approach would also require large amounts of energy, these requirements may be reducible. Implications of realizability overlap with those of traversable wormholes. Researchers describe a CRISPR-Cas9 epigenome editing method for a potential novel treatment of chronic pain. The painkiller was tested with mice and may become an alternative or synergistic addition to opioids for the treatment of pain of multiple origins. A mutation in a gene, or blueprint, for proteins in the membranes of brain cells that conduct sodium ions into the cells was found to be associated with insensitivity to pain earlier, but could not be selectively inhibited via gene editing. The researchers used a novel approach and repressed the expression of the gene, which they left unaltered. Epigenome engineering. Results of a scientific synthesis indicate that, in terms of global warming, the Amazon basin, which includes the Amazon rainforest, is now emitting more greenhouse gases than it absorbs overall. Climate change impacts and human activities in the area, mainly deforestation, cause a release of carbon dioxide, nitrous oxide, and other forcing agents that lead to warming that most likely exceeds the region's atmospheric CO2 uptake. Scientists report SARS-CoV-2 lineage P1 may lead to susceptibility to reinfection after recovery from the disease. Scientists report a SARS-CoV-2 combination of variant B117 and a mutation from the variant detected in South Africa that is less susceptible to vaccines. A cohort study of patients matched by biological similarity finds that variant of concern B117 has increased mortality. The study, based on over 50,000 UK patients who tested positive, found mortality increased in the comparatively low-risk group from 0.25 to 0.41% without controlling for UK vaccination campaign effects. An analysis of leaked and allegedly partly manipulated emails of the European Medicines Agency indicates concerns over percentages of intact mRNA in early commercial batches of mRNA vaccines, possibly reflecting a lack of certainty that relates to their efficacy before 2021. A study finds that the snapshot mass testing in Slovakia end of October 2020, where about 80% of the country's population was tested within a weekend, was highly efficacious. Follow-up tests in 45 countries indicate that it decreased observed prevalence by about 58% within 1 week and 70% compared to a hypothetical scenario of no snapshot testing. A study of data on 500,000 UK citizens shows associations between meat intake and risks for common conditions such as coronary heart disease and diabetes, as well as a lower risk of iron deficiency anemia. A study published a few days later reaffirms some of the study's conclusions, finding that higher intake of processed meat was associated with a higher risk of mortality and major cardiovascular disease. Scientists report the discovery of a species of endosymbiont bacteria similar to mitochondria that allow its host to breathe nitrate instead of oxygen. The scientists estimate that the so far unique protist host integrated the bacterium over 200 million years ago. Study results indicate that limiting global warming to 1.5 degrees Celsius would prevent most of the tropics from reaching temperature-humidity combinations, or wet bulb temperatures, above the human physiological limit, beyond which they are fatal after just a few hours without artificial cooling. A new global food emissions database indicates that food systems are responsible for one-third of the global anthropogenic greenhouse gas emissions. Scientists report that a third of a species of sea slugs could shed their whole body from their head and regenerate it after the body got parasitized. Previously, the largest or most complex life form known to be capable of such extreme autotomy and regeneration was a species of panther worm, as described in a 2019 study. These sea slugs are known to be able to conduct photosynthesis via incorporating chloroplasts from algal food into their cells, which they use to survive after separation from their digestive system. Scientists describe a novel theory for a natural origin of the peculiar and first detected interstellar object Oumuamua. It may be a piece of nitrogen ice ejected 500,000,000 years ago from an impact on the surface of a Pluto-like planet beyond the solar system. They estimate that, if their theory is true, about 4% of astronomical bodies in the interstellar medium can be expected to be fragments of nitrogen ice. Scientists use novel lipid nanoparticles for delivering CRISPR genome editing machinery into the livers of mice to reduce LDL cholesterol levels by almost 60%. A study finds that an optimized, globally coordinated marine conservation could be nearly twice as efficient as uncoordinated national-level planning, and estimates that bottom trawling, towing fishing nets along the seafloor, releases as much CO2 emissions as aviation before the COVID-19 pandemic. A study finds that the severity of heatwave and drought impacts on crop production roughly tripled over the last 50 years in Europe. Physicists report the detection of odoron particles. These were predicted in the 1970s and got detected via particle collisions at the LHC in 2017, which has now been confirmed. Odorons consist of an odd number of gluons, which are carriers of the strong nuclear force that binds quarks together. News outlets report the announcement of the first comprehensive public report on UFO events accumulated by U.S. agencies for June 2021, as required by the U.S. Economic Stimulus Bill. Reports clarify that the data released and confirmed thus far is considered to be only a small share of the material available, and that the relevant footage depicts advanced technology that no state is known to be capable of building. These sightings happened all over the world, including in restricted airspaces, such as over military bases. Scientists report that a delayed change in the shape of early brain cells causes the distinctly large human forebrain compared to other apes and identify a genetic regulator of it. Scientists conclude that, based on new observational data, a collision with asteroid Apophis can be ruled out for the next 100 years. A study estimates that the national trade, consumption, and production patterns of the G7 drive an average annual loss of about 4 trees per capita. A case-control study of cities finds that redistributing street space for cycling infrastructure during the COVID-19 pandemic for so-called pop-up bike lanes lead to large additional increases in cycling. The extensive pesticide pollution risks worldwide are estimated with a new environmental model. Scientists find that a third of global agricultural land is at high risk for such pollution, of which a third are high biodiversity regions. Scientists report evidence of subglacial sediment from over 1 kilometer beneath the ice stored since 1966 that indicates that Greenland was completely ice-free and vegetated at least once within the last million years. A news release by one of the participant universities clarifies that these findings show Greenland to be more fragile and sensitive to climate change than previously thought.